Break up the ice encasing that vantage.
Drove off the bat.
The bat's on us!
Take it to him!
I'll need to evacuate this lab of cryo vapor before the lockdown protocol on this door is disengaged. There's more going on here than a simple accident. This security guard's skin has the same blue coloration as freezing. I should set up a crime scene. Data analysis indicates that he died from heat stroke, but the control room doesn't show signs of overheating. This is some kind of crystallized chemical residue. Traces lead back into the lab. The trail ends here. I should scan for more evidence. Two men struggled. One of them ran out of the lab. That would be the dead security guard I found. These palm prints are a match for Victor Freeze. He must have watched the security guard die. Freeze scavenged what he needed from various prototypes to build himself a super cooled survival suit. Extreme pressure built up inside the tank when ice sealed these outtakes. It appears that this guard was frozen by the cryo vapors from the resulting explosion. The evidence suggests the guard was frozen before the tank ruptured, perhaps by Freeze's cryo cannon. These DNA traces are a match for Victor Freeze. Spatter analysis suggests a blunt impact. Someone assaulted Freeze with a weapon. The cannon was knocked over and fired. When the tank exploded, it released a plume of cryochemicals. The plume enveloped Freeze and the guard, but the shockwave knocked the assailant clear. I need to find that weapon. It may have evidence I can use to identify the assailant. DNA analysis confirms the gun was used to bludgeon Victor Freeze, and fingerprint analysis shows Ferris Boyle. It was Ferris. Something was wheeled through this fluid, possibly a gurney. The fluid must have frozen almost immediately for these tracks to have been preserved. Odd. Freeze was secretly doing research on Huntington's Korea, but this is a cryogenic weapons lab. The test subject was Nora Freeze. Now I know what happened here. Boyle hired Victor to help advance the secret cryo-weapons program within Gothcorp. In exchange, Boyle agreed to devote Gothcorp resources to finding a cure for Nora's Huntington's. But Boyle was more interested in how Victor had managed to put Nora into cryostasis. When Victor realized that Boyle had no intention of following through on their deal, he decided to do the Huntington's research himself. But Boyle didn't like that. The cryochemical cocktail altered Victor's metabolism, as well as the guards. Boyle escaped ahead of the plume and had the lab quarantined. Victor survived, but he knew that leaving the supercooled lab would kill him. So he built himself a suit and utilized an organic supercoolant to keep his core temperature sub-zero. All this violence. He's just trying to save his dying wife. The supercoolant Victor uses in his suit is the same fluid I need for the cryo drill. Alfred, send Gordon the evidence I've gathered on Boyle's crimes.
I'm sorry, Master Bruce. I know you had high hopes for what Ferris could do for Gotham.
That doesn't matter now. Victor's plan was never to kill Boyle. He needs Boyle's security access to get his wife out of Gothcorp. That's all he wants.
And now, you're going to stop him?
I have to.
And are you still going to need that gurney?
I am. But not for Victor.
You know what I'm gonna do when I get out of here? I'm gonna have Candy pour me a nice hot bath. And then I'm gonna drown you in it!
I'm trying, boss. This ice is tough.
Oh, you completely and utterly dead skin! Get over here, you nasty bugger! Put your scrawny little neck in my head, so I can strangle some sense into you!
Boss!
My wife. You can't stop me.
I know the truth, and so will the police. Boyle will face judgment for his crimes.
It was an accident. You don't know what you're talking about.
Nothing matters. Do you understand? Nothing but my Nora.
You've endangered lives all over this city. Nora would never have wanted this.
No. What she wants is to live a long life in the warmth of the sun. Her hand in mine. And because of him, she'll only feel the icy touch of a man whose emotions run as cold as the blood in his veins.
Sir, you can overload those cryo generators using your thermal gloves. Look for the control panel.
You're helping me, Batman, not fighting me. Not allow him to escape again. Where are you?
Demise! This ain't over!
way! I told you not to do that!
How did he escape? See how well you do when the air freezes in your lungs.
Batman for forcing my hand.
crawl. This man should have been more careful. You want to stop me? Then come out of the shadows. Well, that man, come out and do what you came to do.
Escape. Where are you?
get underneath him, I can take him from below.
And the back.
Cryogenic containment failing. Prime subject Nora Freeze in danger.
Kill him.
But you shouldn't have stuck your nose in my business. And here I thought I was going to have a problem explaining what happened in your lab. I mean, the police are never going to look at me after what you did. And with this bat freak dead, there won't be anyone left to say
otherwise. Cryogenic containment failing.
Nora.
And that just leaves you.
Please, you can save her. You just happened to bypass the trial cover.
Victor! She died! I'll keep you alive long enough to see her go!
Breaking news out of North Gotham at this hour, where protest has turned to celebration. Under extreme pressure from Gotham's citizens, Mayor Hill has just announced his resignation. While Hill has not ruled out a possible run for re-election in the new year, his resignation means that Peter Grogan will likely not be the next police commissioner of Gotham. Speculation has already begun about who the new mayor will appoint as commissioner, with many pundits naming GCPD Captain James Gordon as the frontrunner. And now to South Gotham, where Vicki Vale brings us this live report.
Thanks, Janine. I'm standing at the corporate headquarters of GothCorp, where Captain Gordon has confirmed that GothCorp CEO Ferris Boyle has been taken into police custody. Police report that Mr. Boyle stands accused of manslaughter, extortion, and attempted murder. Shocking accusations given that just earlier tonight, he accepted the Wayne Foundation's award for Humanitarian of the Year. Also in custody is the notoriously elusive underworld crime boss Oswald Cobblepot, better known as the Penguin, as well as a GothCorp cryogenicist, Victor Freeze. Mr. Freeze is being held under heavy guard at Gotham General, receiving treatment for an undisclosed medical condition. Quincy Sharp has suggested that Mr. Freeze is yet another example of the type of criminal that needs the specialized care that only Arkham Asylum can provide. Police credit these arrests to solid police work, but this reporter suspects the vigilante known as the Batman had more than a small role to play. On a personal note, I owe Batman a debt of gratitude for rescuing me from almost certain death earlier this evening. So, thank you, Batman. For all of us. Back to you, Janine.
Thanks, Vicki. The Batman continues to be one of the top stories this holiday season. So as we here at GNN wish you all a happy and safe New Year's Eve, we'll leave you with just a few of the comments you've made about Gotham's caped crusader.
I was surrounded. Next thing you know, bam, boom, kapow! The bastards are all on the ground, KO'd. I didn't even see him coming.
Oh, it was all a blur. He just whooshed in out of nowhere.
Listen, I'm a cop. I can't condone what he does. But I can be grateful he's doing it.
Oh, he's real, all right. I got the bruises to prove it. He's real, he's ruthless, and there ain't nothing in the world that's gonna stop him.
Congratulations, sir. Victor, Ferris, and even that scoundrel Cobblepot are all in custody. Shall we call it a night, then?
Not yet, Alfred. There's still work to be done.